Now I would like to give the floor to Ambassador Munir Akram of Pakistan. Excellency, you have the floor, please.
Thank you. Thank you, Ambassador, and yourself. Thank you for organizing this important meeting. And I would like to also express my appreciation for the statement made by Deputy Foreign Minister Nur Yashad, as well as the important information that has been shared by Secretary General Sarabayev. We also appreciate the participation of Under Secretary General Voronsov at this meeting. Dear colleagues and friends, I think we all realize the importance and the potential of the Conference on Interaction and Confidence Building Measures in Asia, CICA. It is one of the most important platforms, includes the widest membership in Asia, and has the potential to contribute to both peace and security as well as development. The plans that have been outlined today are an indication of the potential that we can try to achieve. It is, I think, of course, very important that we must adhere to the principles of the United Nations. That is the place of the birth of this organization when it was first proposed by President Nazarbayev. And it can grow only on the basis of our adherence to these vital principles of the UN Charter. But I believe that we must go beyond just cooperation with the United Nations. This organization has the potential to go beyond and to contribute as a pioneering role in the promotion of peace and security as well as development. I believe that this organization, which has a commitment to address the conflicts and disputes in the region, must take an active role in the promotion of the resolution of these conflicts and disputes. It should frontally try to promote the trust and confidence that we all adhere to. It must try to address the problems that arise from the threats to peace and security in the region. Threats which arise not only from terrorism, but also from the threat of conflict between the member states of our organization. We must address disputes frontally. The dispute over Jammu and Kashmir is a major threat in the region, a major threat of conflict between two nuclear weapon states. And we must try to see if we can contribute to the resolution of this dispute and similar disputes which exist in our part of the world. We must also need to be on guard against becoming a tier four powers who wish to pursue their agendas of competition and geopolitical rival. We must continue to stand against unilateral coercive measures, as well as any politicization of the United Nations Security Council sanctions architecture that undermines the principles and purposes of the UN Charter. As enshrined in numerous declarations of CICA, this forum stands for the peaceful settlement of disputes and resolution of conflicts on the basis of the Charter of the United Nations and the norms and principles of international law, as well as decisions and documents adopted in that framework. I hope that we will create the mechanism under the institutions of CICA to be able to address conflicts, to be able to address military doctrines that are dangerous for the maintenance of peace and security, address the arms race which has been unleashed by certain powers across the world, and we must contribute to the efforts of the Conference on Disarmament and other international forums in promoting international peace and security through disarmament and arms control. On the development side, I believe that the most important contribution which CICA could make would be to accelerate the objective of promoting connectivity between our nations. We are a vast continent. We represent a vast number of countries with enormous economic potential. And projects such as that mentioned by my colleague from Uzbekistan, the Uzbekistan-Afghanistan-Pakistan Railway Convention, projects such as the Belt and Road Initiative of China, the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, these are the kinds of connectivity projects that would contribute most greatly to the promotion of economic and social development on the ground for our peoples as such. As far as the United Nations is concerned, we should take the lead. Take the lead in addressing the problems of today, the vaccine distribution, equitable vaccine distribution. This is a vital issue for many of our countries, and we must ensure that we get results in terms of right decisions for equitable and universal distribution of the vaccine. We must address the financial problems that are facing so many developing countries. My Prime Minister has proposed an action plan for addressing these financial difficulties in terms of debt relief, SDR creation, and other measures of financial support to the poorer countries in the world. CICA could be one of the organizations that could take the lead in promoting such international decisions. So we have great potential. We are totally committed to the vision of that was outlined initially by President Nazarbayev, and the torch is being carried by the President of Kazakhstan and the government of Kazakhstan. We wish you well in your chairmanship. We want to thank Tajikistan in particular for their 2 years in leading this organization, and Pakistan will play an active role and a constructive role in promoting our objectives. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Excellency, for very multifaceted inputs in our discussion.